Hey guys, today's video is going to be about how do you find your edge in the market. Hey guys, this is obviously a question that a lot of people always ask is, what's your strategy? How does your strategy work? Can you show me how you trade? All those type of things. So I think the one thing that's very important to understand is all of us have a different way of seeing the market, identifying patterns, etc. So if you look at price is literally running up or down at all times. So you can either just buy or sell. So just like me and you as retail traders, there's institutions, banks sitting there and they are buying and selling based upon opinions that they are making. Then you have banks and hedge funds trading with AIs. So the AI is based upon market patterns, human behavior, etc. So in effect, we are actually just trading human opinions, and we are trading opinions on where people with bigger money than us think is the market is going. So at points you can trade a reversal, at points you can trade the market jumping in the market as soon as the market's running. And that is where your edge comes in. I can teach you support resistance, trend lines, Fib, all those things. And obviously where everything is getting together is where confidence are made. And I'll do a video on confidence as well, which is very important. But in the end, if you have your analysis in or not, price is gonna sell from this point, buy from that point, etc. If there's no analysis or 6-7 things telling us to buy or sell. So it's very important to remember that you are different from the guy next to you and the trader next to you and the other traders next to you as well, because you have a different way of seeing the market. So what the idea of the video is showing different ways you can actually find your edge, ways you can use to find your edge. So the most important thing, I'm gonna go into the charts just now, but the most important thing is to have a book where you journal your trades. To say, okay, this trade I sold here at this point, this is where my stop loss was, I hit stop loss because of this and this reason. And you need to monitor market at least 5 to 7 days after you got out of the trade to see, maybe I closed earlier, maybe my stop loss was too close and then price dropped to my direction. So there's so many different ways you can actually just use to find your edge. Adding positions, having a little bit of a bigger stop loss, swing trading, day trading, sculpting, so many different things. So let's get into the market and let me quickly go through some charts and explain to you guys different ways of how you can sometimes just adjust your trading to be profitable. Sometimes you don't need a new strategy, you don't need a new course, you don't need a new trading system, strategy, whatever you want to call it. Sometimes you just need a minor adjustment. Sometimes it's just risk. Sometimes you're risking, this happens a lot of times, it's like you're sticking to risk management, then as soon as you take the big risk trade, then you lose that trade. And then you think by yourself, it's like the market knows you're over risking. So let's get into your charts and let me explain a few different things that you can do to find your edge and basically adjust your trading rather than relearn your trading. Because relearning the whole time, you get into this thing that they call the cycle of doom, the Forex trading cycle of doom. You buy a course, you learn that trading strategy, trading way, then you start getting consistent, then you start losing. Okay, so as soon as you start losing, you do a new course. And then you just keep going in that circle the whole time. So just as you're about to make it, you actually just start something new. So sometimes where you're going to do a new course now, you should just do a little bit of a readjustment. And then from there, you'll go back into the profitability loop. So let's quickly look at the market. Hey guys, finding your edge in the market. So let's quickly go through the charts and see how we can actually find our edge. So a lot of times, like I said, you have a strategy, but you're making money, you're losing money. So there's something that just doesn't get you to that point where you're profitable at all times, and you can actually get to a point where you're making your first draw. So there's a lot of things it can obviously be. So number one, the first thing that I need to do is I do predictions, okay? I take a short position there, I do that prediction. So back in the day, we used to call it a trading journal. So we used to actually write down physically every single trade we take. You'll journal and we can actually go back and see what happened.
The reason for that is we need to understand our losses. Obviously, our wins is something we need to study and make sure that we're just not getting lucky, but we're actually just winning. But the losses is the nice thing that we can study to help us better see what we're doing wrong. Let's say you take the short position, price knocks you out, drop to the downside. Okay, that's not a thing that you need a new strategy. That's just something that you might be missing something. So the reason for that, it might be just the fact that there's a FIB a little bit higher. Oh, that's the reason. It just actually went and took out the 78% FIB. So next time when I enter, although it's a little bit of a bigger stop loss, that's the edge now. I'm going to trade with a little bit bigger stop losses because I keep getting knocked out of the market. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a little bit of a bigger stop loss, but I'm going to have two entries stacked there. So what I'll do now is I'll sell on the 61 because it lines up with our selling levels. Okay. And then I'll have a sell order on the 71 and a sell order on the 78 as well. So if price pushes against me, it's actually helping me get a better risk reward. So what happens now is price is then there. And if this order now comes down to that point. So this is another thing. If you can't hold trades, this is a perfect edge for you to implement into your trading and studying it. So now we only need a 1-to-3 risk reward ratio. So as soon as price pushes to the first entry, you can close the second position, first position and the second position and the third position, and we have a perfect 1-to-3 risk reward ratio. Obviously, now if we end up leaving that trade, we're going to have a 1-to-14 risk reward ratio. So that's one thing that you might do. Then number two is you don't have time. A lot of people obviously trade and they just don't have the time to trade. Then you're going to be moving more towards these type of currencies and you're going to be always looking at the higher time frames. So higher time frame trading. What do you do with higher time frame trading? The same thing. You look at the price. There's a high low. As soon as price blows below there, we add off a high to low. So now I'm not going to overcomplicate this. I always wait for breakout structure. As soon as I have a pullback, I enter on the 61 to 78% FIB and I have a starting block. That's it. So that's my edge now, is that I'm focusing on the bigger time frame. As soon as price gets to the 61, I sell, 71 sell, 78 sell, all three stop losses just above, and I'm leaving this trade for the long term to the downside. So that's another thing that you can do, because now you don't need time. You just need to prepare perfectly. So now we've already broken down here, nothing we can look at. We've broken structure there, nothing we can look at. So you just fluctuate or go through the pairs and see where can you actually capitalize. So this is something that you might capitalize on. We broke structure again to the downside. So we don't have a pullback yet, but as soon as we have a pullback, we're going to add our FIB high to low, add a selling block from the 61 to the 71 FIB, and say, well, there's our selling block. All we have to do now is just go put in our positions, add our stop loss back above that, and then have our take profit target set. So that's basically another strategy that we can look at. And then another thing, we always see these guys that flips 5K to 100,000 or 500 Rand to 5,000, whatever it might be. So that's, in my opinion, called leverage trading. Okay, so you have, it's the same thing as having a 1,000 Rand account. Let's just do it in dollars. It's easier. We have a $100 account. So a lot of people will then obviously go and say, well, let's take that $100 and we just flip it. So banks also use this way to trade. So for example, they will have a selling level over there and they will know, okay, well, there's a supply area over there. So what a bank will do is they will have that selling zone. So they will have a short position locked in there, stop loss still above there, and then they take profit extended to the downside. So what a bank will do is they will have 100 orders stacked between that selling level and the top selling level. So if price pushes up, they will keep selling the whole time, ending up with a 1-to-30 trade there at the top. So what people do in the sense of doing, managing their accounts like this, they will then allocate $100 to this trade with all their sell orders stacked already in place. Then they'll open a sub account and do the same thing. So that's one way to do it, is allocating, saying, I'm willing to risk $20 on this trade. then putting a first trade in and saying, well, I'm going to risk $10 on this one, $6 on the second one, and $4 on the final one. So using the same lot size, but obviously as it pushes up, the risk is less. So in that position, I'm risking $20. So you're basically going full in with that $20 on that specific position. So the reason people end up making sub accounts or second accounts, and only risking $20 or $100 on that certain account or trade is because of the fact that if you only have $100 in, you can't trade more than $100. So you have your orders in and you can't overtrade. And the reason that happens is now price pushes up, so you start selling. And then it actually ends up breaking through, meaning you should now be taking a loss. But then you start moving your stop loss a little bit higher, a little bit higher, a little bit higher, and you end up blowing a full $100 account where you should have actually been risking a $20. So that's the reason people do that. That's just a few ways you can obviously look at the market and find your edge, look at what you're doing wrong, and use that to obviously implement and find your edge within the market.
Hey guys, once again, just a big thank you for always supporting me, for always watching my videos. Please remember to like and leave a comment. Obviously, I'm doing all this for free. I decided to take this whole year and just put out free content, free education. So it does support me a lot. Obviously, I want to grow my brand, grow my channel as well. So thanks for watching and thanks for the support.